Manatee capital of the world.
Yes.
Because you're from Discover Crystal River, Florida. You're from Crystal River, Florida, the actual town of Crystal River. So let us know about the manatee capital of the world and what all goes on in Crystal River.
All right. Well, so we're the county tourism agency. It's Citrus County, and we market the whole region. But manatees are our first and foremost. As you said, John, the manatee capital of the world. We are the only place that you can legally swim with the manatees. There's lots of places where you can see them and be nearby, but our area is that's what separates us.
How do you do that?
We have numerous charter captains. Okay. that and it's kind of what we encourage. You can do it, you know, in a kayak or you can paddle up, but having our captain's whole idea is the proper way to experience with the manatees, which is very passive, but you are in the water and they are very curious. They do come up to you, so it's not looking at a distance for the most part. They will come to you, but their whole job is to put you in the water with them, and yep. It's just a better experience. It's much easier that way. And our guides
are
great.
Do you have to go off into the Gulf to do this, or do they come into like an inland area?
No, our season is November to March, and it's when the weather is cold, so the Gulf temperatures become too cold for them because they're mammals, and so it pushes them into our area. We have so many of the high magnitude freshwater springs pushing water into the bay that and our springs are constantly 72 degrees. So that's where they congregate, and we have plenty of food that they like to eat with the eelgrass and things, and so it just makes for a really nice haven for them. And then as it warms up, like it's been this warm last month, they go back out. And we have some residents that stay because they like the area and they like the easy food.
Can you blame them?
No. November to March, and the colder days, the better. There are many times, maybe on the Today Show, you've seen the manatees in a spring, and that's most likely Three Sisters Springs, which is our... it's part of the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Refuge, but that's where you see them, and there'll be so many in there, they look like stepping stones.
Yeah. Now, remind those who are map mm-hmm. challenged,
right.
Crystal River on a map is located where?
So we're on the Gulf Coast of Florida. We are about an hour and 15 minutes north of Tampa and about an hour and a half west of Orlando. We're right above where all the beaches start, from the St. Pete Clearwater area. It's very...
You're north of there.
Correct. It's a very rustic area, and so we don't really have the beaches, but we have wonderful fishing. We have the manatees. In the summer, we have scallops.
Now, Brooksville is somewhere in there, right?
Right. Brooksville is just underneath us, maybe 20 minutes just below.
In a different county?
Correct. That's Hernando County. That's right below us. And we work together with them on some projects, especially bicycling, because there's a state trail that runs right through the middle of both of our counties. And so we partner with them. But mostly our big product is being on the water, whether it's paddling or snorkeling or with the manatees or scallops. It's fishing. It's really being outside on the water.
Now, I know here at Tourism Summit's past, there was a marketing plan. It might have been your area too, but somewhere along that area is the Forgotten Coast or Secret Coast or something like that?
Yeah, I'm trying to remember.
It might be north of you. What do they call that area?
Yeah, there's... there was the Adventure Coast.
That
and,
might be it.
And yeah, there's a couple of there's some
where
marketing
the curve there on the
yeah
Gulf
that's in
Coast.
like in the Big Bend area.
Big
that's
Bend. Okay.
That's yeah, that might be towards Apalachicola and Mexico Beach where they
may
had the
have
hurricane.
Renamed the strategy since yeah. then, but that was their mm-hmm. little ploy at that time.
And right.
It's again not an area a lot of people go to in Florida, but it has things that you're not going to find at Mickey Mouse Land.
No, you're right, right. And I think that especially in the summertime, I mentioned a couple of times about the scallops. It's bay scallops, and you're able to anybody can do it because the water is shallow. You can either use a snorkel or not. And I always point to the fact like people that may have been lobstering. This would be 180 degrees in terms of difficulty from lobstering. I did that once, and I think I'll just buy them from here on out. And if I want one, but the scallops are they just sort of lay there, and you just scoop them up, and you can catch 10 gallons is a boat limit a day of whole scallops. So it makes about a quart bag when you're all when it's all said and done, when they're shelled, because the actual meat's about the size of a marshmallow that you put in a hot cocoa.
Okay.
It's not the big ones like the sea scallops that you get in at the restaurants.
Well, one of the great things about where you are in the Crystal River area is you have that authentic Florida look and feel, and you probably have a lot of people that talk very Southern because they're true, I guess the term is Florida crackers.
Yeah, I think we have a high number of multiple generation Floridians.
There you go.
That's I'm a fifth generation Floridian.
Are you?
My mother's a speech clinician that grew up in West.
What?
A speech clinician. She taught the children how to speak correctly in school. But she's from West Tennessee, and so
where's she from?
Humboldt.
And Gibson so, County. Hello to all of our Gibson County
right,
folks
her,
there listening to us right now, 93.1, the talk of Jackson in all of West Tennessee. So hello, Gibson County.
Yeah. So
they just won a state championship there, I think, the last couple of days since you were into sports.
Yeah. Her father ran a furniture store for about 50 years in Humboldt.
Better give a shout out.
Yeah,
what was the name of it?
Closed now, but it was Weber's Furniture. And my grandfather was a businessman for there for as long as I can remember. And my mom went to UT, but if you can imagine, having a thick Southern drawl would not be good for teaching children how to speak correctly.
I don't know about that.
So,
have you looked at the educational standards of the day? What's a little Southern accent going to hurt anybody?
It probably would have helped out, but so people are surprised sometimes they find out that I'm a native Floridian because I don't have much of a drawl, except for when I get around my other family members from the South, then it picks up a little bit.
Well, good for you. But you can find that true Florida experience in the Crystal River area. Discover Crystal River. Your website is visitcitrus.com and discovercrystalriverfl.com.
Yeah, discovercrystalriverfl.com is our website that's for the public.
Okay.
So like most folks, we're in a perpetual redesign, but it's still up and running, and in the end of the summer we'll have a brand new look. So hopefully it will be much more friendly and inviting. Please visit.
Our listeners who might be in Humboldt, Tennessee that don't want to drive all the way to Crystal River, what are your airline options?
Tampa is the easiest of the two big airports nearby, Tampa and Orlando. Orlando is just over the top busy. But Tampa's a very easy airport, and there's a quick expressway that drops you off right at the southern part
of
our county.
I'm glad you said that. You didn't call it a freeway. You called it an expressway.
Right, yes. No, it's not free.
This boy's from the South.
It's not free.
This is in California down here. This is the South. We don't have no freeway.
Right, but it is very convenient from the Tampa airport to us.
Okay.
And St. Pete Airport they have some of the other airlines like Allegiant flies in there.
Pretty cheap.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah. It's very affordable. They just have shorter options than going into Tampa. But either one is good, and it's like I said, even from St. Pete is maybe another half hour. So,
a lot of good choices. And again, it's discovercrystalriverfl.com, the website.
Yes.
You can go there and fly that cheap airline to St. Petersburg, and save your money so you can splurge.
That's right.
When you get into discovercrystalriverfl.com country, and we can't leave you without, I know this is not a good thing for someone in your position to do, but can you at least give us a couple of good dining options while we're there?
Oh, sure.
Because I don't want to make any, they're all great.
No, right.
They're all great,
right.
But
we have a couple of places. There's a place in Homosassa, which is one of the, it's an area, it's not quite a city, because it's just part of the county.
What'd you call me?
I didn't. It's Homosassa. Homosassa is actually, that's where I live.
I am a Homo sapien. I don't know if you knew that or not.
Yeah. That's good to know. Clear that up. Homosassa, that's actually where I live, but there's a place called The Freezer. It's a working fish, a fish house. It's cash only, but they do have an ATM.
My kind of place.
But it is delicious food. There's not a whole lot of extra presentation or anything, but the food,
kind of place.
Food is outstanding.
Y'all kind of place.
Right. And then now in Crystal River, there's a place I like quite a bit. It's a place called Crackers. It's right on the water.
Good name.
They have a little tiki bar out back.
They got t-shirts there?
I haven't looked.
I bet you they should.
That's right.
Crackers.
But, it's good. One of the best things about it is how fresh our seafood is. I mean, it's right there. The Gulf is very close, and so it's important. And then there's one other one in Homosassa I like it for waterfront dining. It's called Seagrass.
Uh-huh.
And so yeah, they have a really nice patio where you sit out and you look out over the Homosassa River, and so you might see manatees, you might see dolphin, but it's just, you know, the beautiful sunsets as we're on the West Coast, and delicious food and drink.
Well, it sounds like a great place. Of course, I'm not too envious. I'm in Florida right now talking to you, so Florida is a wonderful asset here in the Southeast, but all of our southern states have their own strengths and weaknesses, but not a lot of places in the South can you go swim in manatees.
No.
But you can in the manatee capital of the world, and that's Citrus County in Florida. John Pritchard has been our very special guest. You better say hello to all your family there in West Tennessee.
I will say hello to all the West Tennessee folks and Humboldt Jackson. It's the Weber family was there. There's probably a few cousins still left, but it's that all in the downtown Humboldt was one of my favorite places growing up. Chasing my grandfather to all the banks as he's making deposits, as
making that money.
Right. Yeah. And then we go home for lunch.
Or dinner.
Oh, yeah, supper.
Dinner was at noon.
Dinner, yeah, we had a big dinner and then had supper
then
at
had
night.
Then had supper. And they never question that, because they don't call what Jesus, whenever he had that meal before he was slain on the cross, they don't call that the Lord's dinner.
Nope.
They call that the Lord's supper. So if that's at supper, then you know dinner comes around lunchtime every day. Or should
right.
I say lunch. John, thank you very much.
Thank you for having me.
Appreciate you letting us know a lot more about Discover Crystal River, Florida. John Pritchard, and a former Gator. And what do Gator fans say?
Is wait till next year?
No. I know Auburn's got the War Eagle, and the Landshark fans say the whole hottie-totty thing, but what do Gator fans say?
It's go Gators, and then the signal is the chomp.
Yeah, well, I knew about the chomp, but that's hard to kind of put here on audio. But
right. Go Gators is the
visually,
is big.
Here we go.
That's right.
John, thank you. Go Gators.
Go Gators.
And that, my friends, wraps up today's Y'all Show here from Daytona Beach, Florida. We will be back with you on our Friday edition. It's going to be a lot of fun, as we will hopefully be continuing on. If I don't go swim with the manatees, we'll be right back here in the captain's chair with more of the show that's all about the South, y'all. Go Gators.
Go Gators.